Hello, welcome to Let's Play the Charnel House Trilogy Blind. I'm the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari. Excuse me, this is a blind playthrough, which means I have not played this before. I looked at a few items in the room. I actually thought this was recording and it wasn't, so hopefully this works all right. This is put out by a developer named Owl Cave, who was published by Mastertronic at the time. Interesting, Mastertronic was a really old name. I think it's just a different Mastertronic we're talking about here. It actually published a game called The Demon's Forge, which is a really old adventure game. I don't think it's the same Mastertronic. Doubt it. But yeah, I put up a playthrough of that as well. I actually finished the damn thing, finally. And put up, what do you call it? My little songs as well. I think it turned out quite well. It was interesting. But anyway, getting off the track here. Owl Cave, I'm not sure they would start self-publishing their work, but they're, I don't know if they're around anymore. If so, they've been kind of silent for quite a while. I get the feeling it's people that work for other companies and then they come together and make games on the side, like through this. To Owl Cave. It's been no word that I know of them since 2015. They also put out a game called Richard and Alice, which I intend on playing probably more sooner than later. Their games are, well, this game is made with the Adventure Game Studio, which is the same as anyone familiar with Wajid Eye Games. They, you know, Dave Gilbert, I believe is the name, uses the Adventure Game Studio as well to make his games. Played a couple of his games, intend on playing more as well. Other than that, really, I had to go into Steam settings to get this to work in a 1280 by 800 window, because by default it just ran full screen on my 1280p monitor and looked like complete crap. So, yeah. So anyone who wants to duplicate that, if you go to launch the game or play from Steam, it comes up with a little window, play or settings. So you go into settings and you can do, I think I did 4x nearest neighbor, which ended up being 1280 by 800. They also have anti-aliasing filters and rounded pixels, and I didn't bother with that. So it doesn't always work like you think it should. Anyway, so this is a really short game. Inhale. I notice inhale, and we also have an inhaler here, as well as a little doggy figurine and this light. So this might have something to do with having an asthma attack. I have no freaking clue. You also can find an inhaler in the game, right in the first room before you like did anything. I looked at a few things and then realized I wasn't recording, so. Let's actually begin this the right way, then.
So, it's another good evening to you, my fellow cheated hearts of New York City. Good news! The blizzard's finally stopped.
Yay!
But the weatherman says there's a rainstorm coming.
Boo.
Just what we need, some good old-fashioned New York rain.
Rain is rain.
So close your windows, lock your doors, wrap up warm and settle in for another evening with me, Kenna Martin, exclusively here on BC 304 FM. I'll be taking you all through the night and right up to the graveyard shift, because whoever heard of employment laws, huh? So to kick things off with a personal favorite of mine, here's Forever by Nervous Test Pilot.
Meredith Test Pilot?
It stopped snowing days ago. I ran out of excuses not to go and see him. I don't want to think about this.
So, yeah, you go to the top of the screen just like anything else, any of the other adventure game studios. Go to the top and you automatically get your inventory, which is nothing. Oh, this is the same settings that you can see from the main menu. I put the volume down to, I don't know what this is, 60? 75 or something? So you can hear me over it. And really there's not much else. Interact, use select items, examine deselect items. If you click this twice, you can fast travel to a different room. So I guess that's whatever room she's facing. I'm not sure, unless it gives you a... I think it's whatever room she's facing. Open your inventory by moving the cursor to the top of the screen. Or you elect, I guess, double-click like in a direction, like over here you would double click and fast travel. For all I know, is the, you know, WoW Jedi games had the same. It's been a while since I've played them. Yeah, inventory items can be combined. And I don't want to quit, I want to zoom.
I don't really want to wear a coat indoors.
That's the use, and this is the look or view.
Gavin's old coat. It's been here since... Well, the night he left, I guess. My birthday. Classy guy.
Jerk.
I do wish he'd come and pick the damn thing up, though.
Burn it, baby, burn it! So I guess Gavin is the guy that she's having an excuse not to see, or something like that? I haven't looked at everything. Let's go look at everything that I did.
Playing a game would be perfect about now. If only I could concentrate.
So she has games in there.
Books, games, a couple of CDs. Very me. And an asthma inhaler, for some reason. No idea who left it here. Might have been Sophia. Hope she has another. Although since she hasn't been here for over a month, I guess she does.
Radio.
My trusty portable radio. These days it gets a lot of use. I'd prefer to leave it on. I like the ambiance. A portal to an exciting other world. Or as the landlord calls it, the bathroom. My adorable little pot plant. Gavin used to call him Dave. Called him Gilbert. Gilbert it is.
Dave Gilbert, reference.
There's something in amongst the fronds. I should get it free sometime.
How about now?
Ah, got it. Parcel I hadn't opened yet. Let's see. So you want to give up smoking. A self-help book. By I Burn It. Kinda wish I hadn't found this now. I'll just put it back where it was.
A bit older, though. And you know what I realized? That's me, that is. When I eventually get fired from the station and end up missing talking to you guys so much that I just go full throttle talk to myself instead. So to the anonymous woman talking to herself in Washington Square Park, I salute you. You gave one insecure DJ some hope for the future.
So unfortunately, yeah, I guess I don't know if we're just about at the limit. Or I tried to get in the cabinet, and that's it. Yeah, that's really it. Okay. And I heard her say that redheaded woman in the subway talking to herself. So you really didn't miss anything because she kind of recapped at the end. So it's unfortunate though. They talk over each other.
My DVD collection. I'm not a huge movie buff. Gavin is though. I think a few of these are his. I should probably give them back soon.
Burn them.
Well, shit. It's locked. I don't recall locking it. In fact, I don't recall it ever having a key.
Odd. So we're, yeah, at the limit of where I've played, so this is it. Plus, I didn't look at the potted plant. That was a bonus. Cabinet, radio, phone. I thought I was looking at... Can I move her over? Yeah, I thought I was looking at that before. These are, looks like a stack of books, but I was actually looking at a cabinet.
The door to my apartment. Sure, I'm going to stand around staring at it all evening. The peephole doesn't even work. I've got no desire to go out.
Good, because I didn't want to leave yet. We got stuff to do and look at.
It's a novelty phone. Gavin got it for me. It looks like a crow. There are messages on the answering machine.
Ooh, let's listen to them.
Don't feel like calling anyone, but I suppose I should listen to the messages.
Absolutely.
You have 2 new messages. First new message received today at 1:18 p.m.
Congratulations. You have won tickets to the Krennic on Thames Museum's latest exhibit. Straight from the catacombs of Augur Peak, this is a once-in-a-lifetime chance to...
Tickets to an English museum? This is New York, kids. Not interested.
Message deleted. Second new message received today at 6:29 p.m. Hi, Alex. Dinesh just told me you'd been in. Should have let me know. I'd have made sure I was here. It's been a while.
The nurse.
I'm sure your dad appreciates it, love. You know he'd tell you that himself if he could. Call me on my cell when you get this. Goodbye. Love you. Bye. End of final message.
I didn't call, Mom, because I knew you would be there, and I couldn't do it if you were. I don't know why. Please don't hate me. Ah, screw it. I'll call her in the morning, right? Right.
Hmm.
God damn it. Talking to myself. My therapist says it's my desire for an audience, for company. I say it's because I constantly feel like I'm being watched.
Like someone sitting down, looking at a monitor with a mouse and keyboard. Yes, you're completely being watched.
Ah, the sofa. So many happy memories of sitting here, doing fuck all. I have nothing but love for this sofa. Wait, no, the other thing. Apathy. It's a sofa. Actually, it's a bed, too.
All in one. Gotta love it.
Sure, yeah. I'll go to bed at 7 in the evening. That'd be suitably pathetic. My mom gave me this when I moved here. Gavin had to fix one of the legs a few months ago. Oh god, never mind. It houses a bunch of old games magazines, last Tuesday's copy of the paper, and an ashtray. What a life.
What a world, what a world.
If I was drinking coffee or felt like reading, then maybe. But I don't. So no.
She really doesn't follow instructions.
The kitchen. I'm not actually a bad cook. I just usually can't be bothered. There's something behind the radiator. Maybe I can reach it.
So it's usually with games like this, I usually try to exhaust one certain room before I go into others. So that's why I have not chosen or even tried to go through those doors. For all I know, she'd probably be like, I don't feel like going in there, and just not go in there. I got more stuff.
Ah, got it. A parcel I hadn't opened yet. Let's see. A DVD parcel. Of Strangers on a Train. I bought this for Gavin. Ugh. Back behind the radiator it goes.
Doesn't sound like a good place to put things that can melt and or burn. But that's just me.
A surprisingly beautiful view of the city. One of my favorite things about this apartment. It's dark out.
Alright, so let's look out the window.
Snow might have stopped, but it's still utterly freezing. I'll pass, thanks.
Jeez. You will obey my commands. Okay. Oh, there's the dog from the menu. Lamp.
An unremarkable desktop lamp.
I don't feel like being plunged into darkness right now.
There's something stuck up by the light bulb. I might be able to fish it out.
Why does she stick things in potted plants and in lamps and radiators?
Ah, got it. A parcel I hadn't opened yet.
Another parcel?
Let's see. A 10-foot extendable ladder with stand and carry case.
Very funny.
I'll just put it back.
Well, I got an achievement for that. By the way, guys, you can get this game on Steam for like $5.99 US. Sam?
A memento. Gavin won this for me in one of those claw machines. No idea how he did it. Some kind of wizardry. While I've always been tempted to put it in the microwave, I think I'll leave it here for now. I've grown attached to the little guy. I call him Sam.
You put it in the microwave?
I'd rather leave the lamp alone. The E key sticks, and there's a cigarette burn on page up, but I can't bring myself to part with it. I don't know why, really.
Probably because you can't afford a new one.
I should turn the PC on first. A mouse. I really want a gaming one. Gavin always used to go on about the joy of basic, no-frills hardware. First thing tomorrow, I'm ordering a gaming mouse.
Screw Gavin.
I should turn the PC on first.
Note.
Just my scribblings. Can barely even read it.
You must read it.
Nah, I'm sure it's here for a reason. Probably do an upgrade. They say PC gaming is an expensive hobby. It's not. Unless you're broke. Which I am.
The magazines.
Some games magazine. Every review score is 7 or above. I've already read it. Twice, because that's how exciting my life is. Power on. Good idea.
5 minutes later.
It's a photo of me, with my friends Sophia, Isaiah, and Carly. And that asshole's there, too.
Oh.
It was taken on my birthday a few months ago.
Scribbled out. Scribbled out face.
A photo of Gavin with his face scribbled out. Hey, a girl's entitled to the occasional petty, vindictive outburst, okay?
As long as you did that in paint or something and didn't actually scribble on your desktop.
Nope, not changing it. Let me have this one childish act of rebellion.
I wouldn't even have that photo.
I'm not changing it. I kinda like bitter reminders.
Can I do anything with anything? Can I launch any of this stuff? No. Wait.
Right. Let's do this. Oh, look. Drama, as my favorite reviewer, gives a game a low score. Whatever. I've always loved his writing. Very personable. Makes me feel like I know the guy. Oh well, no time for that now. Gotta track my package. It has to be here today.
Hmm.
Of course. I had to change all my regular passwords. Gavin knew them. God damn it, what did I use here? I think I wrote it down somewhere when I was drunk. Oh, yeah.
On a tower? This?
Ah, here it is, I think.
Now what?
Probably do an upgrade, unless you're broke.
Wait, okay. Post-it note.
The writer walks the shores where love inscribed its final kiss. Time to read, Alex.
What?
The writer walks the shores where love inscribed its final kiss. Time to read, Alex.
That's the hint for the past. That's the hint for the password. It's not the actual password. Okay, exit.
Nah.
Yes. I looked at exit, that's why she did that. Can't go that way.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, let's go through
I'm
here.
I'm pretty hungry, but I'll grab dinner in a bit. Got things to do first.
Okay. I don't think she'll actually go in any of the rooms at this point anyway.
Sure. I could use a shower.
Oh, okay. Do you want to take a shower? I'm attacked by a knife-wielding maniac. 10 minutes later. Wow. Guess you should have... Well, you didn't change. You should have taken a shower while you were waiting for the computer to boot up. That would have been an excellent use of your time. Alright, so we gotta go here and get
the Let's do this then.
Book. Graham Masterton. That's an actual author, isn't it? He sounds familiar. Mirror Sanctum Coastal Walks. That's what we're looking for. Oh my god, she is Atlas Shrugged by Ayn Rand. Megalopolis. Special topics in calamity physics? The Charnel House burial. Cool. So, Leia, let's look at everything.
Sophia's inhaler. Might as well bin this. Tomorrow. Nah, let's not get sidetracked with minor things like asthma. The Mirror by Graham Masterson.
Masterton.
I remember this being pretty terrifying when I was a teenager. I wonder if it'd hold up.
She said Masterson.
I haven't thought about this book in years. I doubt it's the one.
It's this one, but I'm gonna look at everything to see what she says.
Sanctum by Madeline Rue. This just came out. I have an especially strong connection to her writing. I can't wait to read it. In fact, everyone should. Yeah.
I got a metafiction achievement unlocked.
I'm saving it for a special occasion.
Okay, gonna skip coastal walks, go to Megalopolis.
Leaving Megalopolis by Gail Simone. I bought this because I loved her run on Secret Six, but I haven't had a chance to read it yet.
I really like this theme, by the way.
Since I haven't read it, it's probably not this one.
Okay, getting into controversial topics here.
Ayn Rand's Atlas Shrugged.
Ayn Rand.
Beautiful novel by an author whose beliefs I totally agree with. Just kidding. Rand was a fucking troll. I only bought this thing because of Bioshock.
Really? They reference Atlas Shrugged in Bioshock? It's another game I have to get to.
By applying the principles of objectivism to this, I can discern it isn't the book I'm after. Death, The High Cost of Living.
Oh, Neil Gaiman.
Just one of my many Neil Gaiman books.
Gaiman?
All the Ankh-wearing wannabe teenage goth girls in the world can't kill my love of the endless. Also, who am I kidding? I was totally an Ankh-wearing wannabe teenage goth girl.
I love Ankhs.
I'd love to sit down and read this, but nah. Special Topics in Calamity Physics by Marisha Pessel. The only time I've wanted to slap and hug the main character at once. Good book.
Yeah. Yeah, they say it's a good story if it elicits some kind of response from the reader. It doesn't have to be a positive response. This has to bring something out in the reader. And, you know, mission accomplished, I guess.
As shown in Horowitz's 2003 essay, This is the Wrong Book, this is the wrong book. Louis Cassel's The Charnel House Burial. My prized first edition copy. The one memento from Gavin I'll never get rid of. Oh, Cassel. You are a strange and troubled man. I wonder whatever happened to you. For your graduation. Ooh. I hope there will always be room in your spectacular mind for me. You are my island. Love you forever and always, Gavin. Yeah. Yeah, I get it. Cassel famously became a hermit while writing this book. The island he moved to was called Augur Peak. I remember now. Augur Peak 1318.
Is that the book I was looking for? That's the book I was looking for. I thought it was this, Coastal Walks.
50 Great Coastal Walks of the British Isles, Volume 2. I checked this out of the library years ago, then forgot to return it. Don't ask me why. I've never even been to Britain. Hopefully the librarian's forgotten. I can't face the shame of seeing the due date.
So that's not the book. Okay. I was supposed to say something.
Nah.
This is nah to the exit. Okay, so that's the book then.